Hi everyone, my name is Khanh from the TensorFlow team, and today I'll show you how to build smart IoT devices using Raspberry Pi and TensorFlow. If you are interested in the IoT space, you probably heard a lot about Raspberry Pi, the tiny computer that is about the size of a credit card, but it can be a foundation to build many custom IoT devices. Raspberry Pi has been used widely to read and process data from sensors, but now, thanks to the hardware improvement in recent Raspberry Pi models and the software improvement in the edge AI field, you can now run many complex AI models on Raspberry Pi to process unstructured data like audio or video. We use TensorFlow to train and deploy machine learning models. However, TensorFlow was originally built to run on servers with a lot of computing power and memory. So to deploy TensorFlow models on Raspberry Pi, you need to use TensorFlow Lite, which is a framework built specifically to deploy TensorFlow models on edge devices. In this video, I'll show you how to use TensorFlow to make your Raspberry Pi hear and see its environment. In particular, we implement two machine learning use cases, object detection and audio classification. With object detection, your Raspberry Pi can recognize objects from its camera feed, and with audio classification, it can recognize different types of sound picked up by its microphone, like human speech or cat mewing. Let's get started by preparing your Raspberry Pi. First of all, you need to make sure that your Raspberry Pi can run TensorFlow Lite. You will need either a Raspberry Pi 2, 3, or 4, or a Raspberry Pi 0, 2. The Raspberry Pi 1 and the original Raspberry Pi 0 are not supported because they are using a CPU architecture that is not compatible with TensorFlow Lite. Next, you will need to plug in a camera and a microphone to your Raspberry Pi. For recording video, you can use either a Raspberry Pi camera module or a USB camera. And for recording audio, an easy option would be to use a USB microphone. Raspberry Pi 3 and 4 also support Bluetooth microphones, so that's another option for you. And this is my own Raspberry Pi setup. I use a USB microphone and a Pi camera. Besides those, I have a few more things connected to my Raspberry Pi. I added a CPU fan because machine learning models usually use a lot of computing power, so I don't want the CPU to be overheated. Then I have a USB-C power supply and a monitor connected to the mini HDMI port. And finally, a USB wireless keyboard and a mouse. This is how the whole setup looks like. Later in this video, I'll demo some machine learning tasks running on Raspberry Pi using this setup. On the software side, although TensorFlow Lite can run on all versions of Raspberry Pi OS, I recommend you to use the latest OS, Bullseye, for the best performance. You can download the latest Raspberry Pi imager from the Raspberry Pi website to install the OS on your SD card. Check out the URL in the video description. And if you are using Raspberry Pi 3 or 4, make sure to install the Raspberry Pi OS 64-bit version. TensorFlow Lite runs about 20% faster on the Pi OS 64-bit compared to the 32-bit version. You can choose the 64-bit OS from the Raspberry Pi imager menu. Once you have installed the Raspberry Pi OS, the next step is to install the necessary libraries. We use Python to run TensorFlow models on Raspberry Pi, so we should start by installing the TFLite support Python pip package. This library is used to run TensorFlow Lite models. Then you should also install OpenCV Python to capture images from the camera. Now, your Raspberry Pi has been set up. Let's write a Python program to recognize the sound picked up by the microphone. In machine learning, this task is called audio classification. We use a TensorFlow Lite audio classification model called YamNet to write this program. YamNet can recognize 521 different types of sounds, such as music, speech, vehicle, cat mewing, and many more. The model takes 1 second long audio data and returns a list of probabilities showing how likely the input audio belongs to each of the 521 predefined classes. Here is a demo of the model running on a Raspberry Pi. You can see it recognizes speech as I'm speaking. Now let's try some cat mewing. And how about some music playing in the background? Okay, Okay, now let me show you how to implement this demo. You start by downloading the YAML TensorFlow Lite model from TensorFlow Hub. For those who don't know, TensorFlow Hub is a free repo for TensorFlow models where you can download many models created by both Google and the TensorFlow community. You can find the URL to download the YAML model in the video description. The next step is to use the TensorFlow Lite task library to run the model. We start by importing the audio module from the TensorFlow Lite pip package that we installed earlier. Then we create an audio classifier using the YAML TensorFlow Lite model. We need to create a tensor audio to store the input audio data. You can call the tensor audio from file function to load audio data from a web file. The second parameter here is the length of the input audio required by the audio classification model. If you have an audio file that is longer than the model input size, you have to split the input audio into multiple chunks and run classification on each of them. And finally, call the classify function on the tensor audio and get the audio classification result. The classify function returns a classification result object, which contains a list of class instances, each representing a type of audio that the model can recognize. Each class instance has a name, such as speech or music, and the probability score showing how likely the input audio is of the specific type. Earlier, I showed you how to do audio classification on an audio file, but like what I did in the demo, you can also capture audio in real time from the microphone and continuously classifying it. You need to make some code changes to do so. The code that doesn't change has been grayed out, so let's focus on what you need to change. First, instead of creating a tensor audio from a file, you need to create an audio recorder to record from the microphone in real time. Then create a tensor audio as a placeholder to store the input audio. We'll add data to the tensor later. Then we start the audio recording. We create a while loop to keep the audio recorder running in the background. Then for every half a second, we load the latest audio data from the audio recorder into the input tensor. Now the tensor audio is ready, and we can call the classify function to recognize the audio like we did earlier. You can find the sample code for audio classification on Raspberry Pi from the TensorFlow Examples GitHub repo. The repo URL is in the video description. Next, let me show you how to run this audio classification sample on Raspberry Pi. Go to Terminal, and first we'll clone the repository with the examples. Run git clone. Then go to the folder with the audio classification sample. The next step is to run the setup shell script to install the necessary Python packages and download the TensorFlow Lite model from TensorFlow Hub. And finally, run python classify.py to start the audio classification program. And that's all you need to run audio classification on Raspberry Pi. And next, let me show you how to recognize objects in images or videos captured by the Raspberry Pi camera. In machine learning terms, this task is called object detection. We use a model called Action Depth Light for object detection. This model can recognize 70 types of different objects. The model takes an image as the input and then returns a list of objects that it recognized, together with the location of the objects in the image. There's another computer vision task called image classification, and some of you may wonder how they are different. So when given this image, an object detection model can tell you that there are three pairs and the location of them in the image. On the other hand, an image classification model can only tell you that it's an image of pairs. Here's a demo of the Action Depth Light model running on a Raspberry Pi. You can see that it can recognize objects like a keyboard, a remote, or a water bottle. Now let me show you how to implement this demo. It's very similar to the audio classification program that we created earlier. We start with downloading the model from TensorFlow Hub, and then use TensorFlow Lite task library to run the model. Let's start by importing the vision module from the task library. Then initialize an object detector with the TensorFlow Lite model that you just downloaded from TensorFlow Hub. Now, you need to prepare a tensor image to feed the input image to the object detector. You can load an image directly from a file using the fromImage function, and then call the detect function with the tensor image to detect objects from the image. The detect function gives you a list of detection objects, each representing an object that it found from the image. In each detection object, there's an object name, the confidence score, and the bounding box indicating the object location. Earlier, I showed you how to detect objects from an image file, but you can also run object detection on live video feed capture from the Raspberry Pi camera. To do so, first, you will need to import a CV tool, which is the OpenCV module, then create a video capture object to capture videos using the camera. Then create a loop to continuously capture frames from the camera. Because OpenCV uses the BZR format, you will need to convert them to RGB as required by the model. The frame is now a NumPy array, so we can call the TensorImageFromArray function to create an input tensor image. And finally, you can pass this tensor image to the object detector like what we did earlier. Here we use OpenCV for image capturing, but you can also use the Pi camera library if you want. They both capture video frames as NumPy arrays. You can find the Raspberry Pi object detection demo that I showed you earlier in the TensorFlow examples GitHub repo. The link to the repo is in the video description. The object detection model runs at about 6 frames per second. If you need your model to run faster, you can connect a Coral USB oscillator to your Raspberry Pi. And if you want to learn more about Coral, check out the IO talk called Coral, Your Next Generation IoT for AI. And you can find the URL to the session in the video description. Now, I've learned how to do object detection and audio classification. Task library supports many more machine learning tasks, such as image segmentation or audio search. For example, you can feed a model a piece of music, and it will tell you which song it is. Besides the TensorFlow Lite task library, you may also want to check out MediaPipe. It's a library that builds on top of TensorFlow Lite and provides easy-to-use APIs for many more use cases, such as the combined face mesh, pose, and hand detection. Please check out the links in the video description to learn more. Now, you have learned how to do audio classification and object detection using a model from TensorFlow. Although the models can recognize many different types of sound and object, there will be many cases where you want to detect things that the model don't know about. That's when you need to train a custom model. TensorFlow Lite Model Maker is a Python library that allows you to train custom models using your own dataset in just a few lines of code. Let me show you how to do that. For example, if you want an object detection model that can detect Android figurines, then the AffionDet Lite model from TensorFlow Hub cannot do that for you. You'll need to train a custom object detection model. There are 3 steps to do so. First, collect and label the training data. Then train a custom object detection model using TensorFlow Lite Model Maker. And finally, deploy the model by replacing the model you downloaded from TensorFlow Hub with the custom model. You start by taking a lot of photos containing the objects that you want to detect. You can start with a dozen images for each type of object that you want to detect and train a prototype model. But to get a production quality model, you should aim for having more than 100 images for each class. Then use an image labeling tool to label the objects that you want to detect in the images. I prefer a tool called LabelIMG. It's an open source tool that you can download from GitHub. You can find the link to download the app in the video description. Once you have finished labeling your images, you can export the label data to start training the model. To train a machine learning model, you'll need a more powerful computer than the Raspberry Pi. My recommendation is to use Google Colab, which is a web-based tool to run Python programs. It offers you free GPUs on the cloud so that you can train custom machine learning models faster. Of course, you can also use your laptop or desktop to train the models if you want. You start by installing Model Maker on Google Colab or on your computer using pip. Just run pip install tflite model maker. And next is the Python code to train a custom model using Model Maker. You start with choosing the model spec our model architecture for your custom model. Here we use action that's light 0, which is the same architecture with the pre-trained model that we downloaded earlier from TensorFlow Hub. Then you load your dataset using the object detector data loader. Then you start training your model. And after training the model, we use the test dataset, which the model hasn't seen before, to evaluate the model accuracy. And finally, you export the model to deploy on Raspberry Pi. Now, as you have finished training the custom model, let's switch over to Raspberry Pi to deploy it. Deploying the custom model is very, very easy. You can reuse the code in the demo app and just replace the pre-trained model with your custom model. Here's the custom model in action. You can see that it now detects Android figurines rather than Xenor objects. It is very easy, isn't it? You can also use Model Maker to train custom audio classification models. And if you want to learn more about using Model Maker, please check out the tutorials on the TensorFlow Lite website. The URLs are in the video description. So that's all the content for today. If you have any questions, or if you want to discuss with others about running TensorFlow on Raspberry Pi, you can join the TensorFlow forum. It's a place for our developers and contributors to engage with each other and with the TensorFlow team. Go to discuss.tensorflow.org and create your account today. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to the TensorFlow YouTube channel for more machine learning tutorials.